Today we're going to talk about the fastest, quickest, and just cheapest way to self-host N8N. If you're just getting started with N8N, you've probably seen this webpage before. This is N8N's official website, and they've got a few plans to run 8N on their cloud service. So as you can see here, the starter plan starts out at $24 a month if you were to pay for this monthly. There's a couple limitations to this and a couple reasons why you would want to self-host. The first one being that you can only run 5 active workflows at once. So if you're learning N8N and you're trying to run a bunch of different tests and different workflows, this can be quite limiting. Obviously, you can run an unlimited amount of steps or nodes within each workflow, but you'll also be limited by the number of executions. So if you're going to run, I don't know, maybe a web scraper or something like that, that's going to be doing a lot of executions, you might also reach the limit for this. Then you'd have to upgrade to the pro plan, which is quite a jump at $60 a month. And even then, you're still limited by the number of executions and active workflows. So there's a couple reasons for you why you would want to self-host your N8N instance. Today, I'm going to talk about the two best options that I've seen to self-host N8N. And the first one being Hostinger. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. Maybe it's Hostinger, but so if you type in Hostinger N8N, you're going to see a link like this. And go ahead and click that link. And you're going to see that this is quite a bit cheaper at $69.99 per month. So they've got a couple plans down here based on the amount of usage that you're planning to work with. I would recommend just choosing this KVM2 plan. As you see, there's going to be a 24-month term, so read the fine print there, but go ahead and choose that plan and we'll see what we can do there. This is going to take us to the cart page. The good thing about this is that you're not locked into 24 months. You can go ahead and just select 1 month, and this is going to bring the price to $9.99 per month. What you're going to get with this is an unlimited amount of executions, an unlimited amount of workflows, unlimited amount of steps, and that's going to be quite a bit cheaper in the long run, and much more. You'll get a lot more freedom that way. So as you can see here, N8N is selected for the operating system to be pre-installed, I guess. And they've already chosen the best server location for you based on the latency. Looks like for me, it's going to be Boston. So let's go ahead and click this continue button here. And you're going to have to register for account or log in if you've already used Hostinger. So I'm going to do that and be right back. All right, if you're logged in, this is the next page you're going to see. So you're going to fill out your billing information, your payment, and I'm going to fill that out and be right back. All right, once you've submitted your payment information, you're going to be greeted with this screen. This is going to let you create a root password. And then so just put in a good strong password here. This is going to auto-populate. You can add this in if you're feeling it, and then click continue. And all right, so it looks like one more step. We're just going to go ahead and click finish setup right here. And this is going to set up everything for us. All right, now that's finished up. So you're going to hit this page right here, and you're going to want to click this Manage VPS button right here. This is going to take you to your Hostinger dashboard. And so we're just going to click on Manage App right here. And this is going to take you to your setup page. So if you don't have, obviously, well, you're setting up a new N8N instance. So you're just going to fill out this information here, and that's going to log you into N8N. And just like that, you've got your N8N instance set up. From here, you can create a workflow, create a credential. This is exactly like any other N8N instance. And that's that. So the other option to self-host N8N is Railway. So let's head over to Railway. This is Railway's pricing page. As you can see, there's a couple of different plans here. But to get started, really, all you need is the hobby plan. So the hobby plan is going to cost $5 a month. And that's going to get you everything you need to get up and running with it for N8N. All right, so if you want to get started with this, I'd recommend typing in Railway N8N into Google. And then you're going to want to find this Deploy N8N with Workers on Railway. So go ahead and click that link. And that's going to take you to this page right here. Make sure you got the right one. The username will be Jack, created on July 7th, 2023. And it's going to have a lot more projects and active projects than any of the other options. There's a couple of different options for N8N, so just make sure you get the right one. And just go ahead and click Deploy Now. So you're going to want to log in to do this. And once you're logged in, you're going to see these four different items ready to be deployed. Go ahead and click Deploy. And this is going to start creating your project. So this is going to take a little bit to get all the everything configured. It's going to set up all four of those items in your new environment. Now it might take a little bit for this to load up, but if you click on this activity section down here, you're going to see that the four items were deployed successfully. Let's go ahead and click on the primary one right here. For some reason, this seems to be loading very slowly today, but go ahead and click this primary one right here, and then you're going to see this URL right here. Go ahead and click that, and that's going to open up the same setup page that we saw for Hostinger. So it's the same exact steps from here on out. You just set up your user account or your owner account, and then request the activation key at whatever email you prefer. And that's that. So hopefully that's easy for you guys. Obviously, Railway is a little bit cheaper than Hostinger. But as far as ease of use, Hostinger might be a little bit more user-friendly on the dashboard side. And again, it will be usage-based. So if you are storing a lot of workflows or you're storing a lot of data within those workflows, you'll have to kind of weigh the pros and cons of each one. But hopefully that's helpful for you guys, and see you in the next video.